Coach Lonergan, when you first arrived here, you talked about the style of basketball that you like to play, you know, up and down, fast pace, things like that. Do you feel like with the group that you brought in and the personnel that you have now, that the team that you have this year is closer to the idea that you had in mind when you first arrived on campus?
Yeah, definitely. You know, I think that we'd have been crazy not to take advantage of Martin Kamesh and Chris Holmes, the size we had. You know, I wish we had some more of that size this year, to be honest with you. But we're definitely going to be the most athletic team, you know, we've had since I've been here. And it allows us to press and, you know, to run a lot more. And, you know, Nick and Joey Cooey and some of the depth we have now at guard, I think we'll be able to get up and down the court and, you know, play to our strengths and hopefully score a lot more points. The 2 years ago were very good, but I don't think we were a whole lot of fun to watch all the time, so we had to grind it out with our defense and our rebounding. But hopefully that'll be there this year. But we'll be, you know, a lot more exciting to watch. And a lot of those, because, you know, Marcus got one of the most exciting players in the, you know, in the country. So I think it's worth the price of admission. But I think it'll be a lot of fun to watch us play. And also some of the opponents we're playing are pretty good. So, you know, it makes it for a much better experience for our fans. And I forgot to mention my assistants. I always do that. And wouldn't be here if it wasn't for them. They do a great job. They're great guys, great recruiters. And you know, I owe them a lot. And you know, I think I'm the best staff in the country, too, at any level. I really believe that, at least the best assistants. But Haj and Matt and John Becker and Matt O'Brien, our new guy, I've been blessed with good assistants and managers everywhere I've been. So I want to publicly thank them for all their hard work.
You guys both talked about your comments about expectations. Do you sense that from the community at large, that there's a lot of expectations from both your teams coming into this year?
Well, yeah, no, and I like that there's expectations. I mean, I read the school paper, that's what you want to call it, the other day, and you know, the guy, his quote, he said something like, a really very disappointing loss to UNBC in the semis. And, you know, I know we've been to 5 straight championship games, but it was disappointing for about 2 hours, but you know, UNBC was by far the best team in our league last year. We were up 5 with 4 minutes left. And we're disappointed, but it's 5 months later, I don't consider that a disappointing loss. I give our guys a lot of credit. They played well in that game. I thought we had a pretty good season despite the injuries. We're just very inconsistent. So the expectations are there. We were picked second in the league. You know, we got a lot of guys returning, but we lost some 3 very good players. And we're going to miss them. So we got to make sure that Mojo replaced Kyle's leadership and fill that position for us. And we really, since Chris Holmes left, we haven't had that big banger to compliment Marcus. So we have some weaknesses we got to address. But, on paper, we have probably more depth than we've had. Hopefully, we can overcome injuries because some of our young guys have gotten better. And I think we have some newcomers that can make an impact right away.
Yeah, I think I felt definitely an increase in the excitement level in the community for women's basketball. Definitely, by far, this is the most excitement I've felt year 6. But in terms of pressure, I think the most pressure we'll feel, it's all from within. You know, whether the poll came out as us number one or not, we already felt the pressure that we have a lot of talent. Now that talent's mature, so we have expectations and pressure that we've put on ourselves to get it done. And, you know, the poll might have added a little bit in there, but that's what we want. You know, I think we'll do very well under the gun, so to speak. And that's what Division I basketball players dream about, is to play top teams, to be under pressure and have high expectations. So we're right where we want to be.
I want to piggyback on the expectation question for Coach Lonergan. With such a difficult non-conference schedule, what are your expectations for those games?
Well, you know, I try to not get hung up on a record too much early, and I'm not a good loser, but you know, we're probably going to take some losses with the schedule we're playing. But you know, my goal is just to get better by January, and it's not going to be easy. But you know, last year we played 8 out of the first 9 on the road, so at least we're playing a lot of these games at home for a change. And if we can get good crowds, you know, that should really help us. But I just think some programs, they might win 20 games, but they're not really playing anybody. And we I think our administration supports the overall student-athlete experience and playing high-level teams and going to nice arenas and traveling. You know, I think that's what it's all about here. But it definitely helps toughen us up for the conference. And I think But more importantly for me, I think it really helps recruiting. You can tell kids that play the toughest non-conference schedule anywhere in their conference year in, year out. And I think the kind of kids that we're getting and that, you know, are here today, they want to play, you know, they want to play some big name out-of-conference opponents.
Players, Marcus, you know, obviously you had such a great year last year and brought a lot of excitement to the gym. Coming into this season for you personally, for the guys, you know, Coach talks about expectations. What are your guys' expectations, and how confident do you guys feel coming into this season?
Our first major goal this year is to buy a team defense and really have that whole team effort when it comes to defense, because that's what we know is going to win games. Last year, we let up here and there, they come back, and that would get us out of the game. So, I mean, total team defense, but that's what we stress in practice. So, our expectations of where we're ranked high in preseason poll for defensive percentage, I think, and rebounding. So, I mean, that's one thing that we're proud of and we're going to try to keep on.
Marcus, how you feeling?
Feeling good. Practicing now, so.
Is there any concern that you are you going to be able to practice at this point without concern?
Yeah. I mean, right now, I'm not worried about my foot or any injuries. I'm just trying to go out there, get the chemistry of the team together, and hopefully go out there.
What are you seeing just from the roster as a whole as far as the talent left? And, you know, as soon as this weekend it's in the exhibition, what kind of team do you think the fans will be seeing on Sunday?
It's going to be an exciting team. I mean, a competitive team too, because since I've been here, that the last countdown took off was probably one of the most competitive ones I've been in. So, I mean, everybody has the heart and the fire to just go out there and win, and they don't want to lose. So. And we're going to bring excitement as well as a lot of competition to the team.
Nate, we talked to Coach at the beginning about how this team's grown up, and you're one of those players in the last couple of years that's grown up together as a unit. What do you see from this team? Do you feel like that you guys have a chance to do something special this year?
Yeah, most definitely. I feel that we're a total family. As you said before, we have 6 seniors, 4 juniors. We're a big group, and we've grown up together. And what we see for us is that we're hoping that we're going to win the American East and go to the NCAA tournament. But with that, we do know that there's a lot of tough teams out in our conference, Hartford, BU. So we know that we have to work hard every day, challenge each other in practice, and do whatever we can to get that championship. So we know we have to work hard. It's not going to be easy for us to get it.
Coming so close to getting the NCAA, you got a postseason bid last year, but coming so close to getting to the NCAA tournament, how much of a motivation was that in the offseason?
Yeah, that was definitely, that game against BU was definitely a learning experience for some of us. It was a tough loss for us to handle, but definitely going to NIT was a great learning experience for us. We learned a lot just by playing in the postseason, and we grew up a lot in that semifinal game. I know personally, I grew up a lot just after that whole experience.
Coach,